This video is about Peugeot 407. This is for those who do have concern in buying Peugeot 407 or trusting the vehicle to be good enough to serve them. But so, for the 407, like I've said in most of my videos on that brand, or maybe the comparison, I mean, my videos on the model, not brand, and also comparing it with other Peugeot vehicles. It's a very good car, and it's very sporty, very flashy, it looks modern. I mean, I don't know how. It's a very good car. I drive it a lot. I done all kinds of work. I mean, it's a car I would recommend. And I know, I believe I pointed out most of the majority of his weaknesses, just like every other car have. It's not like it has a lot of negatives or weaknesses, but I just I pointed out the ones that you should be concerned if you are buying and how you can prevent them, like the suspension. You know, I do always mention that the 407 has a weakness when it comes to the suspension. Not that it's not a performance suspension or it doesn't make the car handle very well, no. What the weakness is on the cost of maintenance, not necessarily durability, but cost of maintenance. It's a complex system, so it has so many bushes, this and that. You know, when you don't see the design, you understand what I mean. So if you are using maybe a car that has a simpler suspension system, and you do the same distance on a bad road with a 407, you may end up spending maybe like 5,000 repairing the other one. But a 407 may spend 20 or thereabouts. So how can you not prevent the suspension from failing? I've talked about it on many videos. Don't speed with one on a bad road. When I'm talking about, I'm leaving all this bottles, you know, even when you are climbing bump, don't speed on the bump. You see people when they are driving and get to a bump, they just maintain the same speed they were coming with before they get to that, but just maintain it and climb it with speed, expecting nothing will happen to the suspension. I mean, you have to be stupid not to know that it has an effect on the vehicle. You know, same thing if you are driving on a road that have a lot of potholes, reduce the speed. I mean, like I said, be logical in life. As you are climbing in, driving slowly, or in fact, as you are driving on road with potholes, you usually don't feel comfortable, even no matter how good the suspension is, while you are inside the vehicle. You know, because you will be throwing you about, the car will be doing like this, in and out, going up and down. You know, so you know that even you, that has already been, even the impact has been reduced by so many components of the vehicle, the suspension, this and that, the shock absorber, the tires. Even tires also contribute to reduce impact of the rough road to get into the driver sitting on the seat or passengers, you know. So you know that it doesn't feel that comfortable driving on those rough road and all that. So imagine when you are not speeding and you still expect that the faster you go, that it doesn't have more effect on the suspension. So that's the thing. Some things, I don't know, call it common sense, but you see people do it a lot. So you have to, if you do it a lot on other model of cars you have, or you've used before, or you are currently using, or you are considering getting a 407, my advice is, you have to do it differently on the 407. for you to be able to enjoy the ownership of the vehicle. But because like I said, it may only two components may fail on the other one, but on 407, it may fail more than 7 or 10 thereabout components may fail on the suspension. If you drive it very harshly or in an abused way, because to me, you're abusing the vehicle, speeding with it where you shouldn't speed. You know. So if you do that, why wouldn't it serve you? At least eventually they will wear out, whether you are speeding on the off road or not. Eventually, all those components will wear out. You know, but at least, if imagine if it takes maybe about 2 years, 3 years for you to work on your suspension, on your 407 suspension, and spend maybe 30,000-50,000 naira or much less to replace all those components that are failed, it's worth it. I mean, their shock absorbers are very good, they last very long. So it's one of main suspension. I'm not even referring to the shock absorbers. Even though, no, suspension is part of the shock absorber. Shock absorber is part of the suspension, but I'm saying it's the other component of suspension that I usually refer to as the weakness of 407. So you can be, can prevent it, can last you for years, can still do, even when you are traveling, in that case, you know, it's inevitable, especially on Nigerian roads, because most of our roads, highways have potholes, so you have no option, you have to be jumping them on high speed. Because, like I said, they're inevitable. Before you know it, this and that one, before you know it, that and that one, before, you know, so you just have to, you try to avoid the ones you can and jump the ones you cannot. So, in that case, yeah, you could say maybe if you travel with it once in a often, maybe. Every 3 times or 5 times a year, if the roads you drive on for those long distances are not good, you could say maybe the trips may affect the suspension and you have to replace them maybe once or twice a year, depending on the fault, the part of the component that you failed. Or part of the suspension component that fails. So the things are, other than that, I mean, 407 is a very good car. You have to drive it to understand. The engines are very cheap to maintain. The petrol engines in 407, both 4-cylinder and V6, they are very cheap to maintain. So the parts are very much available, all for the 407 parts. So, well, honestly, if you are interested, get one. All you need to do is apply preventative maintenance, don't abuse the vehicle. I mean, you serve it for years. I know people who have actually changed their 407 like 3 times. I'm serious. As in, they will buy one, use for some years, maybe a few years, then sell, buy another 407. Or they may use it after a while, they'll say, okay, let me try another engine or the same 407 they'll buy. So if the 407 was that bad for them and or dealt with them, why would they buy it the second time? So I would recommend it if you're interested. I've talked about all the positives, most of the negative positives and few weaknesses of the vehicle. You can watch them on YouTube, go to my channel, you see them. If you're interested, I can always get you a good one to avoid buying one that has been messed up by trouble. In as much as I recommend it, doesn't mean you just go to the market. If you don't know how to detect a good one, you go and buy one by yourself and then you end up buying a nightmare. Remember, it's a modern car. All kinds of electrical gadgets and electrical controls. So it's a complex system. The electricals are very complex. So it will serve you as long as you don't abuse it. If you buy one that is abused, or you buy a vehicle that is not abused and abuse it, the car vehicle 407 will deal with you. Any 407 in such condition will deal with you mercilessly. So if you want to buy and keep it in that condition, but I'm not saying it's going to remain like that forever, but at least just do the normal wear and tear. There's a fault, a good thing about 407, any kind of fault that has an electrical connection in other words, even the engine, the gearbox, like automatic gearbox, if there has any fault, immediately to detect and tell you this is the problem, this is, as long as it has a electrical is connected to whatever that's causing that fault. You know. So you use you know, drive and expect that it's a, you need to wait for the car to now start showing you the symptoms. When the symptom has become obvious for you to now do the repairs. So, because when they are about to fail, they will give you warning, even though the car might still be running, but to show you this is weak or this is about to happen, take care of it and continue. You know. The ATF is available. ATF for the automatic transmissions, they are available. The manual gearbox oil for all the manual gearboxes in Peugeot 407, they're also available at least here in Nigeria. Recommended one. I think I did a video on that already. If I'm not, I'll do it. You know, the engine, all their petrol engines, their oils are available. Recommended oil available in Nigeria. So I don't see why. I mean, if you're having a problem owning a Peugeot 407, if you are always complaining about your Peugeot 407, then the problem is not the vehicle, it's you. Because everything you need to have to enjoy Peugeot 407 is available and very easy. It's not a complex car to maintain. In other words, it's not difficult to maintain a Peugeot 407 and it stay in good condition. I mean, this vehicle, Peugeot 407, is what's the age now? 2004 to 2010. So they're already old vehicles, and these cars have been used in Europe for years and now being shipped into third world countries and all that. So you don't tell me that those people over there, if they were using it roughly or abusing it, will you be able to get them in these neat and clean conditions that we are getting them? So the problem is not the vehicle, the problem is the users in Nigeria. The Nigerians have a very bad maintenance culture. So they always look for a vehicle to blame when they don't want to accept that the issue is with them, not the vehicle. So it's a very good car. If you subscribe, if I'm the one that will get you one, do pre-purchase inspection, search for one, inspect, recommend to you to provide. You also can the consultancy is also included so that I can help you in guiding how you can maintain the 407. If there is any issue, I will be able to explain to prevent you from taking it to a park that will do try and error and mess up your head. We also, I always recommend you get your own scan too, so you don't have to keep looking for who is relying on other person that may misguide you. Mislead you to do waste your money changing what is not bad. So for now I charge like 30,000 naira. That's the minimum I charge for pre-purchase Peugeot vehicle inspections and consultancy services. So if I'm interested, can I get you one for you? If you have any other person that can do it for you, go ahead. But like I said, don't go and buy a messed up one and say Peugeot vehicles are bad, or you buy a good one and mess it up yourself. I mean, this is my Peugeot 607 phase 2. I mean, you have no idea how complex this vehicle is, yet the 407 is not as complex as this one. So if I can maintain this one for years with no issues, what's there so difficult in maintaining a 407? So, I hardly scan this car, honestly. I'm telling you, I hardly put scanner in this car, because what do I need to put the scanner for when it's not showing me any need or giving any symptom that will require me to scan the vehicle to know what is causing? No, it's no issue. I don't touch it. I don't mess with the electric cars, because if you don't mess with it, who mess with you? When the problem is only a small issue happens, people will take it to quack. They will start cutting and joining, do all those kind of things on the electric car, doing so many things. And by the time, even most times, the owners will be there looking, or even be the one giving those people permission to go ahead and scatter their wires, mess it up. Then tomorrow they'll start complaining. You know, so that's a responsibility. Buy a 407, it's a very good car, I recommend. Yeah, so. I mean, you need to drive one. Look for a very clean one and test drive. Don't you understand? Personally, I prefer manual, 24/7 manuals. But you know, people are different. Some people prefer automatic. So the automatics are also there. The difference is the automatic has a higher cost of maintenance. The maintenance cost is much higher than using manual. Because of the ATF, it's more expensive and you have to be changing it regularly. So if you want to enjoy the if you don't want the gearbox to fail on you sooner than you expect. But it's supposed to last longer, last a while before they start, before they wear out. So the only way to keep them from failing is using the recommended ATF, which costs more than the non-recommended or the cheaper fake ones. The reason, because about five people contacted me recently, for the past 2 days now, about five people have contacted me. They watch my videos on 407, and they became interesting to them. And they are considering buying it. So that's okay. Yeah, I can do a follow-up. So go ahead, get one. You enjoy it. If you are not sure of how to get a good one, then contact me and do it and get one for you. However, I don't buy. I don't get involved in abused vehicles. So if your budget. Is budget for the abused ones, those cheap abused ones, I'll not get involved. So don't even bother in that case. If you want a very good one, contact me and I'll get you one. And which the user costs more than those abused ones. If you want abuse, good luck. I'm not involved. I won't be involved. Okay, that's all.